لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم تقبل منا أعمالنا ويسر لنا أمورنا واشرح لنا صدورنا ولك الحمد يا ربي كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملأ ما شاء الله من شيء بعد كما تحب يا ربي وترضى ولك العتبى حتى ترضى ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we still with the Al-Kaba'ir, the major sin, which the Imam al-Zahabi wrote a book about it, contained 70 kabira. And we said Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran al-Kareem, إن تجتنبوا كبائر ما تنهون عنه نكفر عنكم سيئاتكم وندخلكم مدخلا كريما. If you avoid the major sin, all the other sins will be forgiven and you will enter a generous entrance, which it is the meaning of it, الجنة. المسجد الكبيرة كل معصية فيها حد في الدنيا أو وعيد في الآخرة. Any sin Allah سبحانه وتعالى put a punishment for it in dunya, like the stealing and like the zina and like the other things mentioned in the Quran or the Sunnah, or there is punishment for it mentioned in the Quran or the Sunnah in the hereafter, this will be considered as kabira. أو ورد فيها وعيد بنفي إيمان. Or Allah or Rasulullah said, whoever commit this kind, he is not a mu'min. أو لعن, or a curse of Allah upon him. Or Rasulullah said, لعنة of Allah upon him. أو تبرؤ, Allah or Rasulullah said, we are innocent from him. أو ليس منا, he is not one of us. أو عذاب, there is a certain kind of punishment, big punishment for him in the hereafter. أو غضب, or Allah angry, or wrath of Allah upon him. And we already explained, alhamdulillah, رب العالمين, that الشرك. And we explain some of its kind. And we'll go to explain more, inshallah. But now Imam al-Zahabi, he said the second kabira is القتل, the killing. Then the third kabira coming, inshallah, Sih, the black magic. Then, after that, number four, abandon and neglect the prayer, the five daily prayer, or some of it. Then, preventing the zakah, and going on, inshallah, with more explanation about it. Now, the kabira thaniya. Second kabira. Allah Azza wa Jal say, in Surah Al-Nisa, verse number 93. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما.
Listen carefully. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, and whoever kills a believer intentionally, his recompense, his punishment is hell, jahannam, to abide therein forever. And غضب الله عليه, the wrath and the anger of Allah upon him. ولعنة, and the curse of Allah upon him. Do you remember when we said the definition of الكبيرة is, if Allah say غضب الله عليه, or Allah say لعنة الله upon him. Here in this ayah, he said Allah is angry, and the wrath of Allah upon him, and the curse of Allah upon him, and a great punishment is prepared for him. وَأَعَدَّ, as Allah said, وَأَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. Allah prepared for him a great punishment in the Akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, also in Surah Al-Furqan, when he talk about Ibad al-Rahman, the most worshipper one to Allah, the one who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and near to him, Allah describes him with some description. One of it, listen, in this ayah, Furqan, verse number 68. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرٍ. Whoever does not call other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means they do not do shirk, which already explained the last time.
وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقَّ.
And they do not kill anyone, which Allah forbid you to kill anyone, except with a just cause. Just reason means Sharia mention about him. He killed somebody else. This is in Islam. He should be killed because of he killed.
وَلَا يَزْنُونَ.
This is one of the kabair also. Does not commit zina. Does not commit fornication or haram. Or anything related to it also is forbidden.
وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا.
And whoever commit that, he will get great punishment. And the great sin he committed.
يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة.
His عذاب, his punishment will be doubled at the day of قيامة.
ويخلد فيه مهانا.
And he will stay there disgraced.
إلا من تاب.
Allah opens the gate of tawbah, gate of repentance, and I accept from whoever you want, subhanahu wa ta'ala, till your soul coming out. Before it comes out.
إلا من تاب.
Whoever repent, وآمن, believe, practicing his religion,
وعمل
عملا صالحا, and he do a righteous good deeds. Listen also, brothers and sisters in whole world, about Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 32. Allah said,
أنه من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا.
Listen, if anyone killed a person, not in relation of murder, kill innocent person, he does not commit any wrong, then you killed him for no reason, or and to spread mischief in the land, it would be as if he killed all mankind. Even he already killed only one. Allah will consider it in Quran Kareem, as I told you, Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 32,
as if he killed all mankind. Listen, وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَا النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا.
And if even anyone saved a life, saved a person from being killed, it would be as if he saved the life of the all mankind. Look how great is it when you save somebody, and how great sin is it when you killed anyone. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned a lot of ayat in Quran al-Kareem about that. Also, sunnah. One of the destructive sin will destroy you, destroy your deeds, good deeds, which Rasulullah said, اجتنبوا السبع الموبقات. Save yourself and avoid and be far away from the seven destroying sins. What it is? They said, what it is, Ya Rasulullah? Shirku billah. Committing shirk is the first one to explain.
Wasihru,
black magic, and whatever related to black magic.
وقتل النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق.
And killing anyone which Allah forbid you, as the ayah saying, whoever kill anyone, as if he killed the whole human being. All mankind.
إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ.
Except with a just cause, which is described by Islam.
وَأَكْلُ مَالُ الْيَتِيمِ.
Eating the property of yatim, of the orphan.
وَأَكْلُ الْرِبَى.
And eating or swallowing or using riba. With a lot of ahadith and one of the major sin. And a lot of ayat. Already talked to you and said, listen carefully. Using riba or interest or anything related to the riba, you should know that because of Rasulullah and Allah himself never say to the one even who commit zina, to the one who even commit shirk,
Me means Allah. And my messenger, Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, both of them, in a war against the one who do riba. Allah does not say it about the one who do shirk. Allah does not say, I am and my messenger against the one. And in war against the one who does not who does zina. But Allah say about the one who do riba. That Allah and Rasulullah in war against the one who using riba. This is, will give you a feeling how big is it. And riba, usually interest is not one level. It's too many levels. 70 some. The lowest part of it is like the one who commits zina with his own mother. Walayyazu billah, ask Allah save us. Ask Allah save us. For that, avoid it completely. You have no excuse in front of Allah to say. And even if you have any excuse and any apologize, it will never be accepted from you. Because Allah already warned you. Allah said, and Rasulullah said, I am and my messenger. Allah said in the Quran, فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. It is a war from Allah and Rasulullah again is the one who uses riba. Allah does not say this ayah or part of ayah about anything else of the kabair except only riba, because of it is major sin and because of it is major bad will happen. Also, running away from the battlefield and the 7-1 insulting and saying bad things about the chaste woman, which she does not commit nothing, then you say she did this and did that. This is one of the major sins also. Narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. A man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, أَيُّ الذَّنْبِ أَعْظَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Which is our sin is the greatest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ أَنْ تَجْعَلَ لِلَّهِ نِدًّا وَهُوَ خَلَقَكَ. To put a rival with Allah or to worship somebody with Allah, to do shirk. While he is the one who created you, the one who gave you rizq, the one who gave you life. قَالَ ثُمَّ أَيْهِ. He said, what's next? فَقَالَ أَنْ تَقْتُلَ وَلَدَكَ خَشْيَةَ أَنْ يَطْعَمَ مَعَكَ. To kill your son out of fear that he will share your food. Means, he will share your rizq, your income. He said, what else? He said, أن تزاني حليلة جارك. To commit zina. This is in general. And especially in this hadith mention, with the wife of your neighbor. It is more. Zina Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention ayah confirming this. This hadith confirm that Rasulullah s.a.w. said, the greatest is the shirk. Number two is the, as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, killing was our topic. Then number three, zina. Listen to the ayah. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرُ. Who does not call any other than other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means they do not commit shirk. This is number one. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. They do not kill anyone except with a just cause. And it's not for everyone to kill anyone. Saying, oh, this is just cause and kill. No. It is some people like a judge. It is some people who is, this is their authority. And after they investigated and see. It's not for everyone you want to do will apply it. No. Already you have the ayah. That whoever kill a person. As if he killed the whole human being. And whoever saved a life. As if he saved the whole human being. وَلَا يَزْنُونَ. The third one, do not commit zina. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم narrated by الإمام البخاري and Muslim, إذا التقى المسلمان بسيفيهما فالقاتل والمقتول في النار. If the two Muslims meet each other with the sword and with have intention to kill each other, both of them will be in Jahannam. Both of them will be in hellfire. They said, Ya Rasulullah, this is a killer. Killer means this is he deserves to go to hell. What about the one who is being killed? قال رسول الله لأنه كان حريصا على قتل صاحبه. Because also he have intention to kill him. Means, if they are, both of them have the intention to kill each other, both of them will be in hellfire. But if one of them have the intention, the other one will try only to defend himself, and he have no intention to kill the other one, then he will be saved. Also, as Imam Abu Sulaiman rahimahullah, he said, this is if they do not have defending himself, or he tried to defend his family, or when they will be both of them in Jahannam, if they kill each other because of enmity between them, because of the dunya, because of position in the dunya, because one of them want to be higher than the other one. For that, with this way, if they have both of them intention to kill each other, they will be both of them in Jahannam. But if he defend himself, or defend his family, or defend his property, then Allah will protect him, as long as he have no intention to kill him. But suppose with the time of defending, something happened. For that he is ordered to defend yourself, but without intention to kill. Means from the beginning, if you have the intention, by any way I will kill him. No, this is what Allah doesn't want you to do. Also, whoever fighting against the one who is do mischief in the land, and he try to save himself from him, but the other one he tried to kill him, do not have intention to kill him. Try to save yourself without killing, but defend your own self, push him far away from you, and try to save yourself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, لا ترجعوا بعدي كفارا يضربوا بعضكم رقاب بعض. Do not be behind after me and behind me killing each other and cutting the necks of each other. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, also narrated by Imam Bukhari and Imam Al-Hakim, I'm sorry, لا يزال العبد في فسحة من دينه ما لم يصب دما حراما. Everyone will be saved, will be protected, will be good, in good shape in his religion, as long as he does not shed any blood, any forbidden blood for him. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, also the first thing you will be accounted about at the day of Qiyamah, about the blood. First thing you will be asked. Also Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, narrated by Imam al-Nasa'i wal-Bayhaqi, and also in Muslim and Nasa'i and Tirmidhi, لَقَتْلُ مُؤْمِنٍ أَعْظَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ زَوَالِ الدُّنْيَا. Killing a believer is more greater with Allah than the destroying of the whole worldly life. If the worldly life, all of it destroyed, is a sin and bad and wrong, killing one believer is more sin than the destroying of the whole worldly life. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الكبائر the major sin, إشراك بالله شرك وقتل النفس التي حرم الله and killing anyone which Allah forbid you to do واليمين والغموس and breaking your oath when you swear by Allah, by the name of Allah, then you break it. نريد by الإمام البخاري ومسلم والنسائي وسميت غموس لأنها تغمس صاحبها في النار. غموس means one of the meaning, because of it will make him go down and deep in hell. For that, this is the meaning of ghamus, going down and deepen something. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said also, لا تقتل نفس ظلما إلا كان على ابن آدم الأول كفل من دمها لأنه أول من سن القتل. No anyone will be killed except the first son of Adam, which wins Habil and Qabil, was fighting, and Qabil killed Habil. Qabil is the first one who commit killing. For that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, any killing by ظلم, by wrong way, happen, he will take share of the sin of this one, because he is the first one started. And it is narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. Not only with the Muslim, because they say the believer. Even about the one of Ahl al-Kitab, or the Mu'ahad, people of the scripture. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من قتل معاهدا لم يرح رائحة الجنة وإن رائحتها لتوجد من مسيرة 40 عاما. Whoever killing anyone of the people of الكتاب, Torah and الإنجيل, he will never smell Jannah. Rasulullah does not even say he will not enter Jannah, he will never even smell it. And the smell of it, you find it before you reach it 40 years. Narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam al-Nasa'i. And here Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, whoever killing mu'ahad, that the one we have a covenant with him, from the Jewish or from the Christians, then you break this covenant and you kill, it will be a problem for you. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من آذى ذميا فقد آذاني. whoever insult any one of the people of the scripture, not only even killing, even insulting them, Rasulullah considered as if you insult Rasulullah himself. For that means, be careful. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ألا ومن قتل نفسا معاهدة لها ذمة الله وذمة رسوله فقد أغفر ذمة الله ولا يرح رائحة الجنة وإن ريحها لا يوجد من مسيرة 50 خريفا صححه الإمام الترمذي. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever kill any معاهد, when we have covenant with him, means when he come to the Islamic land and he have a covenant like the visa, it's a covenant between you and him, then you break it and you did something wrong against him, or you killed him, you will never smell the smell of Al-Jannah. In this hadith, narrated by Imam Tirmidhi, he said the smell of it will be found before you reach it 50 years. Not only that, narrated by Imam Ahmad and Imam Ibn Majah, he said, من أعان على قتل مسلم بشطر كلمة لقي الله مكتوب بين عينيه آيس من رحمة الله تعالى. Listen carefully, please, to this hadith. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever even does not kill, but he helps somebody else to kill someone, to kill another Muslim, even with half word. Rasulullah say, بشطر means half, كلمة means a word, not even with a word. A half word you said it and it was a reason for the other one to kill this man. He will meet Allah written between his eyes, آيس من رحمة الله. He have no rahmah because of what he did. He will not get the mercy of Allah upon him because of what he did. And also narrated by Imam al-Nasa'i wal-Hakim said, كل ذنب عسى الله أن يغفره إلا الرجل يموت كافرا إلا الرجل يموت كافرا أو يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا. Any sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive it except somebody die kafir, disbeliever in Allah, or killing any believer intentionally. We will stop inshallah with this and the coming the next one inshallah for Imam al-Dhahabi about al-Kaba'ir, the major sin, which it is the al-Sihr, the black magic, and it is very important to learn it. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana, Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina, Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar, Allahumma arihna wafrihna wasturna wala tafdahna, Allahumma taqabbal minna a'malana warzuqna al-ikhlas fil qawli wal-amal wa na'udhu bika min ash-shirk ونعوذ بك من القتل ونعوذ بك من السحر ونعوذ بك من كل الكبائر يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم خير المسألة وخير الدعاء وخير النجاح وخير العلم وخير العمل وخير الثواب وخير الحياة وخير الممات. اللهم ثبتنا وثقل موازيننا. اللهم حقق إيماننا وارفع درجاتنا. اللهم تقبل صلاتنا واغفر خطيئاتنا. اللهم اشرح صدورنا ويسر لنا أمورنا واغفر لنا ذنوبنا وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك وارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية وأرحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا. اللهم أرحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا ونسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم وكل خير سألك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك اللهم من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من كل شر استعاذك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم بارك لنا في أموالنا وبارك لنا في أولادنا وبارك لنا في أبنائنا وبارك لنا في بناتنا وبارك لنا في زوجاتنا وأصلح ذات بيننا وكرمنا يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار ونسألك الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزاكم الله خيرا.
ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا. ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا.